and welcome to the family entertainment edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? I'm sure you're keen to get into that hot seat, so let's get started. Okay, let's take a quick check on the rules. Up to four of you can play the game, and each of you will need to choose adult or junior questions. Then, for the first time ever, you'll be able to choose the type of questions you'd like to answer. There are three categories: general knowledge, entertainment, and sport. Simply choose one and stick with it. All you need to do then is answer the 15 questions that stand between you and a virtual £1 million. As always, you can walk away at any time, and there are the usual three lifelines available to you. Ask the audience, 50-50, and phone a friend. If you make it all the way to a million, you could be jetting off on a luxurious family holiday by entering our competition. So grab your remote control and let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Select the difficulty and category of questions you'd like to play. So, you want to answer the traditional general knowledge questions. Good choice. Let's see how far up the money tree you can go, starting with five questions to get you up to £1,000. Have a look at question one. Well done, that's a great start. A nice easy question for £200. Well done, two out of two for you. Now, you've not used any lifelines, so they are still all available if you need them on this £300 question. Nice and easy, these. Well done. Let's get you up to £500 with question number four. That's the right answer. You can guarantee yourself £1,000 if you can answer this question. That's correct. You've made it to the £1,000 mark. That's what I like to see. Five correct answers and £1,000 safely in the bank. This is where things hot up a little bit, though, as we try and turn that £1,000 into at least £32,000. Here comes question number six. Now, remember, you still have all three lifelines remaining. Okay, you want to ask the audience for a bit of help. Audience, I hope you know the answer to this one. Serious business. Grab your keypads and all vote now. Well, the audience don't seem to be able to make their mind up. The most popular answer there was D, but was it enough of a majority to persuade you it's the right answer? Okay, you want to use your 50-50 lifeline. Computer, can you take away two wrong answers for us, please? Well, you'll be pleased you went 50-50. It's helped you win £2,000. Okay, a chance to double that £2,000 to £4,000 now with question number seven. The very best of luck. Here it comes. Very well done. That's the right answer. You've just won £4,000. Okay, let's have a look at the situation. You have given me seven correct answers, and you are now just seven more correct answers away from me asking you a question for a virtual £1 million. You have only one lifeline left to help you, but it's not impossible, and it'd be really nice if you could at least get to the next big milestone. First things first, let's get you up to £8,000. Lots of luck. Are you sure you want to play this question? You had £4,000. You now have £8,000. Very well played. Okay, things are getting a little bit more serious now. £16,000 is a lot of money. And that's how much you can win by giving me the right answer to question number 9. The drop, if you get this wrong, though, has gone up to £7,000. So think carefully before you give me an answer. You had £8,000. You just doubled it to £16,000. Well done. Okay, let's pause for breath. You have £16,000. Get this next question wrong, and you will lose £15,000 of that and leave us with just £1,000. However, get the question right, and you'll be guaranteeing yourself £32,000. You can use your only remaining lifeline, your phone a friend, if you don't know the answer. Lots of luck. Here comes that question. If this is right, you've won £32,000. It is right. You're assured of a big win. So, you must be feeling pretty pleased with yourself, and rightly so. £32,000 is now the very least amount you'll be leaving the game with. We'd love you to turn that into £64,000. You can do that by giving me the correct answer to this next question. You still have one lifeline available should you need it. Lots of luck. Here it comes. You had £32,000. You had nothing to lose going for this question. As it turns out, you had everything to gain. It's the right answer. You just won £64,000. Right, things are going really well. Amazing how quickly you can turn £32,000 into £64,000. But let's just calm down a bit. The next question is worth £125,000, a huge amount of money. You do not have to play this question, but you've still got a phone a friend lifeline available, should you need it. Here we go, the very best of luck. Well, you could have walked away with £64,000. Maybe you now wish you had. You shouldn't, though, because you've just won £125,000. It was the right answer. Did you really think when you started out that you get to the point where I would be asking you a question for £250,000? Probably not, but it is about to happen. Please, please do not give me a wrong answer, and phone a friend if you aren't totally sure of your answer. Let's see what happens as we look at question number 12. Right, this is serious business. You've just decided to play on a question for £250,000. I can tell you, it's the right answer. You are £250,000. Wow, things are still going very well indeed. You just keep giving me the right answer and I keep handing you bigger and bigger and bigger sums of money. I do have even more money that I could give you, starting with a virtual check for £500,000, but only if you can answer this next question. Right, this is a very big moment in the game. Are you confident that's the answer you want to go for? You just risked £218,000. You had £250,000. You now have £500,000. Amazing. You are one of our biggest ever winners. Well, I'm not sure I've ever asked someone the £1 million question without them having already used up all of their lifelines, but you do now have a real chance to take out the million. And you might as well take advantage of the lifeline situation, even if you are sure you know the answer. Let's hope in just a few moments' time we will all be celebrating. Here comes your 15th and final question. Of which gas is dry ice a solid form? Carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, helium, neon. You need a bit of help from one of your friends then. No problem, could be a good move. Pick somebody to help you out.
Oh, brilliant. Thanks for ringing me. It's A. The answer is A, definitely.
I'd go for A on the back of that if I were. And I have to check that you are really going to play this question. Is this your final answer? Amazingly, you've decided to play the £1 million question. Now, you could have walked away with £500,000, but instead, you are walking away with £1 million. You're a winner. Fantastically well done. Not only have you won £1 million, you've also got the chance to enter a draw to win a fantastic, all-expenses-paid family holiday. Just text the winning code to the number on your screen. Very well done, and thanks for playing the Family Entertainment Edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?